So, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Nice to be here again. I met some of you last year during a similar session. My name is Henrik Malmqvist. I'm the head of the EUPOL COPS mission since 1st of January last year and have now been in office since 15, 16 months ago. I would like to start saying that I think what we have seen in Palestine in terms of institutional building for the last years is a lot of progress in building sustainable Palestinian institutions. And I'm now referring to my field, which is security. Police is part of security in Palestine, and rule of law, prosecution service, courts, prisons, and civil defense, which are the areas we are covering in the EUPOL COPS mission. According to our mandate, we are supposed to contribute to the establishment of a sustainable and effective policing arrangements, as always under Palestinian ownership, which is a very basic and a very important principle for us to respect, and in accordance with best international standards in the wider context of security and justice sector reforms. So in this context, we are a quite unique body as a mission, since we are, as I said, supporting the entire criminal justice system. We're not working with civil justice, only with criminal justice, which means that we're working with everything from police to prison, so to say, including the right to defense. So the whole criminal justice chain is really our focus. With me today, I have not only the police, but represented by Brigadier Josef Osrael, who was here last year as well, but also from the Attorney General's Office, Chief Prosecutor Salem Yarar, who is also a good counterpart for us in the mission. I'm happy that you are here with us here today, and I know that our guests are very interested to brief you about the achievements as they see it in their respective fields of work, police, prosecution. So I think I will stop here for the time being and give the floor to you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's my pleasure to be here again this year. I was here last year. We were talking about the Palestinian police and the European mission in Palestine. We talked last year about the achievements, the obstacles, the challenges, the weaknesses, and the strength in the Palestinian police. This year, I would like to say that the Palestinian police, with the support of the European people and nations, and the EUPOL COPS, we have achieved a very steady steps in improving and enhancing the ability and the capabilities of the Palestinian police. Today we meet again to assure you again that fear and security cannot be the same. They are the opposite. They can never be the same. There is no security and no peace and no life for a fearful person. Security is a feeling of reassurance, and it's a feeling of peace and safety. We have been doing this for our people after the long agony they have been under by the siege of the Israeli occupation for the past 50 years. We have improved our capacity and capabilities in the Palestinian police with our own professional officers, since we have the potential for that, and with the support of the European mission in Palestine. This year, because of this effort, we have been awarded by the Pope, Paulus Johanna II, the present from him to the Chief Police of Palestine. And this year, we have been awarded so many presents from the Palestinian constitutions, Palestinian institutions, and all the international and Arab world. We are hoping, and we have taken in consideration, to have a Palestinian democratic, really professional and modern police for the coming independent Palestinian states with its capital, Jerusalem. And to implement the slogan we are always saying, "الشرطة في خدمة الشعب," that means we are the servers of our people. In the other hand, we have to take the consider the new era. It happens last week, and that's the reconciliation between the West Bank and Gaza Strip. And in this case, we need more support and more efforts coming from the whole world and the international community to help the Palestinians to make this reconciliation goes well for the coming years. If we talk about the police, we are talking about the police in Gaza. This police, about 14,000 people, they are being out of work for the past 4 years, so they need lots of help, and they need to be rehabilitated and rebuilt again and to be supported, and this needs a lot of efforts from the Palestinian, the European community. On behalf of me, on behalf of the Palestinian Chief of Police, I would like to thank every European citizen and all the Arabian people for their support to the Palestinians and to the Palestinian police. And I would like Mr. Henrik for all the efforts he has been doing for the past 1 year and a half, and for all the European mission which they have been staying in Palestine for the past 5 years. They have been doing a fantastic job, a very wonderful job, and we are improving because they are there. Last year, we have finished a rehabilitation center in Jericho, which cost more than $7 million. That's the support of the European people, and it takes it, the capacity of that building is 165 prisoners. We're almost there to finish the training center in Jericho, which costs more than $30 million, and that's supported by the European people. We have held tens and tens of workshops and lectures between us and the European mission in Palestine. And they gave us, they consolidate us with everything we need. About the achievements for the Palestinian police, last year we went to the the Excellence Program. It's a European program, and we are now committed to excellence. And this is the second institution in the whole, in the Middle East, after Dubai, is going to this kind of program. And this is a big achievement for us too. We minimized the killing crimes from 44 last year to 27 this year. We minimized the spread of drugs in Palestine from 1,000 cases to 630 cases last year. And we built a new compound for the police in Ramallah. We have rehabilitated and rebuilt again more than 3,000 officers in the Palestinian police. We have found a strategic plan for the Palestinian police for the next 3 years, and this is going to help us to improve our capacity and our work in Palestine. We have implemented and executed over 98,000 cases with the judiciary system in Palestine last year, and that's a very huge number concerning what's going on now. We have a memorandum of understanding between us and the media, and we have a memorandum also with all the universities in Palestine. And we have a memorandum between us and the schools to give lectures and to teach them how, what's the role of the Palestinian police is.
مساء الخير.
Good evening.
أنا اسمي سالم جرار وأنا أعمل رئيس نيابة الجرائم الاقتصادية في فلسطين ورئيس وحدة التخطيط في النيابة العامة.
My name is Salim Jarar. I am a chief prosecutor in charge of economic crimes and I'm also the head of the planning unit at the Attorney General's office.
السيد هنريك مالمكويست رئيس بعثة الشرطة الأوروبية في فلسطين، السادة أعضاء البعثة، الزملاء في الوفد الفلسطيني، أعزائنا مواطني الاتحاد الأوروبي.
Mr. Henrik Malkmus, head of the EUPOLCOPS mission, my fellow delegates from the Palestinian delegation and members of the European representatives.
لقد شاهدت من موقعي كرئيس لوحدة التخطيط في النيابة العامة وإدارة المشاريع.
Through my position as the chief or director of the planning and project management unit within the Attorney General's office.
وخلال الثلاث أعوام الماضية جهودا عظيمة لقسم سيادة القانون في بعثة الشرطة الأوروبية.
I have seen great efforts been made by the rule of law section of the EUPOLCOPS mission.
حيث يقوم هذا القسم بتقديم المساعدة التقنية للنياب العام في فلسطين.
This section provides technical assistance to the prosecution, to the Palestinian prosecution office.
وهذا الجهد هو يعني جهد الاتحاد الأوروبي في إطار الجهود الدولية التي تقدم في مساعدة لمساعدة الشعب الفلسطيني في بناء مؤسساته.
And this is part of an overall European effort. This European effort is part of an overall international effort provided to aid the Palestinian people in building in its institutions.
في إطار قطاع العدالة في الحقيقة يعني للمرة الأولى بدأ الالتفات لهذا القطاع منذ يعني ما بعد سنة 2006 حقيقة.
As for the justice sector, for the first time there has been attention paid to this sector following 2006.
ومن أجل يعني النهوض بهذا القطاع بدأنا بإعداد خطة استراتيجية للنهوض بقطاع العدالة بكافة مكوناته في فلسطين.
And in order to further develop this sector, we have prepared a strategic plan to raise the level of the justice sector as a whole with all its components.
في الحقيقة بعثة الشرطة الأوروبية ساعدتنا في الخروج بأول خطة استراتيجية لهذا القطاع وكانت يعني على امتداد السنوات من 2009 لغاية 2011.
The EUPOLCOPS mission helped us in preparing this first strategic plan for the justice sector, which covers the years 2009 to 2011. As well as to the subsequent plan from 2011 to 2013.
بدأت مساعدة وحدة سيادة أو قسم سيادة القانون في بعثة الشرطة الأوروبية للنيابة العامة بإرسال عضوين من هذه البعثة للإقامة في النيابة العامة وبدء العمل معنا يوما بيوم.
The assistance provided to the prosecution from the rule of law section began by the rule of law section sending two members to be co-located within the general prosecution office.
كان لي الشرف أن يعمل هؤلاء الأشخاص معي في وحدة التخطيط للنيابة العامة.
I had the honor of working with these two individuals within the planning unit of the Attorney General's office.
بدأنا نعمل سوية لكي يعني ننجز الخطة الاستراتيجية وبعد ذلك امتد نشاط هذا القسم لكي يقوم بالتنسيق يعني ما بين المانحين لزيادة الدعم للنيابة العامة في إطار جهودها للتطوير.
We began to work together on preparing the strategic plan. After that, the activities were to coordinate the relationship with the donors in order to develop the prosecution.
استطعنا من خلال الجهود المبذولة من خلال هذا القسم أن نوقع على اتفاقية تعاون ما بين المحاكم الفلسطينية والنيابة العامة الفلسطينية في إطار اعتماد برنامج لحوسبة النيابة والمحاكم.
Within the efforts of the rule of law section, we were able to reach an agreement of cooperation between the courts and the prosecution within the framework of adopting a program to computerize the system of the courts.